And you are most welcome to make an offering.
Absolutely. You're an absolute divine floofer. Why should I? No. Your eyes are two baleful jewels that strike fear into the most complacent of rats. Your paws are fit to overturn only the daintiest of crystalware. Ooh. Your glorious tail can trip an unsuspecting servant with the grace of an empress. Try and pet the cat. I like four. Your glorious tail can trip an unsuspecting servant with the grace of an empress.
Oh, you flatterer.
Anything Larian got the cats absolutely spot on this game?
Of course, correct. My tail is quite the mark.
I like how the whiskers and the eyebrows have little kinks in them.
Unwashed rabble who frequent this establishment have much to learn from your deference. And I must suffer their foibles alone. Oh,
such a shame.
But they do say a burden shared.
Yes, the way that the paws shift, yes. A little bit of kneading. What's that shady pair over there whispering about?
Can't you hear from here? They're talking about the new top cat in the criminal underbelly. Go and listen for yourself.
Ooh.
As for them personally, one never washes and instead douses himself with rose oil, while the other can't hold his drink.
Do I want to know about who throw those fancy curtains?
The drow. Two of our most popular courtesans. A night with them seems to be rather life-changing.
I think my life has been changed a lot recently.
Of course, they are siblings. But judging from the throngs of clients they draw, most of the city is as disgusting as they are.
What are your thoughts on the clientele as a whole?
That's rather a broad topic. We get all sorts here. But there is one frequent visitor whose very presence offends me.
Is it a dog?
He dresses fabulously, but stinks of the hells.
Is it Raphael?
Infernal, to be sure. Abhorrent.
Monsieur Chapeau, Queen Roll the Despoiler. Okay, so that's not a private room. That's just, okay, there's just. Tonight at Charis's Caress.
Cabaret here featuring Roll the Despoiler. The highest kicks in Baldur's Gate guaranteed.
Okay, let me do this main room first. Let's go to the back here. Some of this vibe is giving me a very, like, we should be playing Vampire the Masquerade all of a sudden, you know? Citizen, okay. Ear Spoon and Borgus Elamin. One of them is drunk, one of them never bathes.
The two men bark softly to each other. A single name reaches your ears.
No, I've never played The Witcher.
Nine fingers.
Ooh, save history failed. But we can maybe perceive. Or maybe we can't. All right, we're stacked on inspiration. We'll use one. I don't suspect this is very important, but we do keep capping out on it, so what the heck.
You rats with the guild now. Heard Nine Fingers met a match.
The new kingpin? All meat and muscle, that one. And wild as a werebear. If he's looking to oust Nine Fingers, my blade's got his back.
Sounds messy as the ninth hell. Must be why she called us to help.
Is that right? The way I heard it, you Zent cut a deal with the new... Hold on. You there! Getting up in our affairs!
Sounds like an interesting business I'd like to take part. Hearing private matters in a brothel, read the mind, attack leave. I mean, let's do a little mind reading. Wow, that's pretty easy.
Nine Fingers won't be happy about Zenovia, and I'm not about to tell her.
I need to talk to Nine Fingers about Zenovia.
Better you than me. Now listen, I'll only say this once. Lower City, Basilisk Gate, Guildhall. And that's all you're getting from me. Now scram! The chat's officially closed.
Okay.
God, music's trouble. You and I. tell you now.
We will continue dancing.
Yeah, yeah, you got that right.
You're looking parched, sweetheart.
You're looking green.
Another tankard.
Else, darling.
Oh, she must be a Sylvan elf.
What
else?
Spill over. But other anchoring for spicier flavors. How about you give me a taste?
Uh-huh. Just looking here, so unimpressed. Is everything all right? I think it's time you got out of here, buddy. Watch silently. Probably deals with herself perfectly fine.
What'd you say, doll? Have a sit on my lap. Let's see what pops up.
Darling, how you set me a quiver. You are a beast among men. No, a dragon, setting my phoenix nest aflame.
She doesn't have to work that hard. He's like, okay, dude.
I shall slake your thirst, dragon. You will part your lips and drink of my essence.
I will drink your essence.
Hoots, order up! Another tankard for the feast.
Just gonna get him drunk.
Damn, somebody. Hoots. That new batch burns stronger than a pit fiend's fist.
I'll take that as a compliment.
Take it however you want.
Get but major Karlach vibes from Hoots.
From now on.
Something's off about this one. On your guard.
Oh. It's Raphael's favorite misadventurer.
Oh?
You've put me out of pocket, you know. Raphael bet me 5 soul coins you'd reach the city in one piece.
Is this the one that smells of the hells?
He rented a room upstairs in the hope that you'd drop by.
Okay. Who are you exactly?
Ah, I forget. We've never met. I've had my eyes and ears on you so long, we feel like old friends.
You pissed her off when you scared him away.
Yeah. I'm Raphael's assistant, shall we say.
Are you
Take your time. Have a drink. Sample the goods. Go see him when you're feeling refreshed.
Give it a good rumple.
What is this? I think we're getting Hoots and Shadow Hoots.
Now, that there's a face I'd remember if I'd seen it. Welcome to Charesse's.
Yeah, that's all the veins.
What can Hoots do for you, stranger? You got a taste for ale, I reckon. Or maybe... Ah, forget it. My new brew could drop you in the wink of a spectator's
eye. Hey, listen. I won a drinking contest against some sort of undead monstrosity that was, I think, something like 90% liquor by itself. I can handle this. Your new brew sounds potent. I'll give that a try.
Don't know about that, chum. Hoots Hooch packs a stronger wallop than all...
He double visioned without having had a drink yet.
Could beef you up, sharpen your tongue, or knock you out cold.
Oh, is it going to be like bonuses on persuasion?
Until the first drop hits your gullet.
Stop, stop. I've already been sold. I'll take my chances on the hooch.
Damn.
Karlach approves. Yes.
Knows what he wants.
It's when I know I did the right thing.
First one's on the house. So, don't come bawling to me if your big toes fall off or your tongue coils in a knot.
Okay. What's the story of this place?
Charesse Caress. The mamsel's brainchild. Wet your tongue, soak your skin, scratch your itch. Get the attention you want, and avoid the attention you don't.
At a barkeep in this place hears all sorts of stories.
My business is slinging tankards, not hoarding secrets. I'd like to
say,
I
think a barkeep in this kind of place that spills secrets doesn't stay a barkeep very long.
Have a look.
So I got my Hoots Hooch. Well, probably went in our supply bag. Amulet of the Drunkard. While wearing this amulet, regain 2d4 hit points per turn while drunk. Additionally, increase the duration of your inebriation by 5 rounds. Holy crap, that's a lot of healing. Per round? While drunk. I don't know how long being drunk normally lasts. That seems insane. Okay, I think most of this... Oh no, you can bonus action. Okay. Yeah, I know there's a couple other things with drunk. You can do like a drunken monk build. It seems like a huge amount of like out of combat healing for cheap. Like, Karlak's got some damage, right? You know what? Yeah, I'm gonna buy it. Ooh, the Hoots Hooch is really expensive. We got one for free. Hang on, let's get a couple of bottles of wine for Karlak. Although, actually, I'm realizing the wine prices are similar to just healing potions.
Hey, good looking.
I'm actually not sure how much a win this is, but I gotta try it. Did I buy the amulet for you? There, amulet of the drunkard. What are you currently wearing? Oh yeah, Misty Step. Oh yeah, we've also got this eternal carafe of wine or sometimes acid. Oh, wine's the expensive stuff. That's part of the problem. So, did that give you the drunk? Yeah, there you go. And are you healing? Oh, you're not drunk. You just have alcohol. Didn't give me a second alcohol bottle. Okay, well, she's clearly drunk, but she's not healing.
Let's move.
Don't burn yourself.
Now, do we have to be in combat or just not in turn-based mode? She lost hit points here from the acid. Well, that seems overall kind of pointless, but I guess we got a funny toy we can play with. All right, we have Asterion with us. Good. Go find. Well, we got to go upstairs to check out the librarian's room for the mystery. Plus, Raphael is somewhere. Balcony. AP per turn per bug. Yeah. I got my money back. Man, we spent a lot of money this stream. Nymph's Grotto.
Brothel? Pleasure house?
Oh.
Den of decadent delights.
Okay. Apparently. Oh, there we go. Elminster's library.
Loudly in the library at all times.
We have a key. Surgical bed? Anyone caught pleasuring themselves in the library will be tethered to the bookcase of chained books. Any wizard caught examining the special collection without express permission will be commanded to read aloud to the whole library the passage they were enjoying. Anyone breaking the silence of the library will be promptly gagged. Oh, there's a journal somewhere. Born to be wild. Well, these are all going to be saucy, aren't they? This unlicensed, certainly libellous? Pamphlet describes the content. This magical adventure, the one and only Elminster, explains the inaccuracies of Tavolo of his accounts of the mating rituals of the Feywild, with very graphic demonstrations. Oh my god, it's fan fiction. The butler's cane has a knob on the end. Yoshimo is willing. This revisionist, sensationalist novella with a blurb. In this alternate history sex adventure, the one and only Yoshimo does not betray the Balspawn. Spoilers! In fact, he does almost anything the Balspawn asks for very readily. Wow.
trust no one.
Maybe later there, Asterion. Woo!
Never a dull moment.
I'm fine. I'm fine. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm fine. Everything's fine. Oh, it's a bath! There's sponges, soap! I see!
These boots have seen everything.
Okay, journal over there. Dog collar. Uh-huh. He's getting worse. The whispers, the night terrors, the blood. I know he's hiding something, and the others in the flophouse know it too. I've seen how they look at him, how they look at me. They're scared of him. I can't blame them. I am too. So the flophouse. Mountain's journal in the pleasure room. Seems terrified about something happening to someone dear to her and scared the patrons of the flophouse will have noticed. Maybe we'll find answers there. Go to Frago's flophouse. I think we've got a few name drops of that place. The one that got a fae? Slow-paced enemies to lover's tale featuring a bitter archwizard of fae and his nemesis, a pure-hearted, muscled berserker. Then from the Quarta Sune, a guide to sexuality, eroticism, and emotional fulfillment. Detailed diagrams accompany every page. Ooh, another rooftop option. That must be Raphael right there. Yeah, speak with the devil, but hang on. I don't see anything at a glance, although presumably we can go over like rooftop to rooftop, especially with a fly spell here, or to access some extra areas. Let me go back inside, though. See if you can find Raphael's spot. That's a book about Edwin and Minsk. Oh my god! You're right! Wizard of Fae, a berserker? Devil's Den.
Devil's Den.
Knock, knock. Voss is here.
You must hear me, devil. I will do whatever it takes.
Dude, no! Don't sell your soul!
Anything you ask.
There is only one thing in this world that I desire. You do not have it. And you never will.
He's a ranger. He's a berserker ranger, though.
Help me, Raphael. For the sake of my people.
Hush now, Voss. These guests may not know it yet, but they want the same thing that you do. And unlike you, they have something of value to offer in return.
Whatever you discuss with this devil, I must hear of it. Find me below in the taproom once you're loosed from his claws.
Okay, Lizelle wants your sword.
I'm glad you came. Not to my door, not yet, but to the final reckoning. One more thing before we begin, though.
I wondered about that, the scar. I didn't remember him having that scar. What is happening? What is happening?
For the first time since the Nautiloid, your mind is clear. It's
Are you just
unsettling.
Breaking the connection to the Emperor? Yeah, she didn't cure us. I'm assuming he just broke the connection temporarily. I'm gonna go with you. I feel empty. What did you do?
I gave you back your privacy by shutting that illithid in your pocket out of your mind. It can't hear us.
Huh. What's the catch?
We should really go for a long rest. I trust Elithid more than I trust you. I think Del does feel that way. Speak freely. Tell me why you brought us here. Clever. When we first met, you promised me a cure. This isn't a cure. Yeah, but I don't think the cure from him, I don't know how much of a winning path that is. And at this point, how much does Del still want to be cured? You know, does... Is he like, I don't know, this partial ceramophosis is sort of working out. Maybe we can just leave it there. Speak freely. Tell me why you brought me here.
I brought you here because I'm true to my word. And I can make all of this
Tell me in your brain at this point.
Go away. Which means you and your lovely friends can remain blessedly free of tentacles. Unless some have already sprouted in places I can't see. Let us speak plain. I'll admit, you've impressed me. I wasn't sure you'd make it this far. But
we had the saves come
a
little.
How far you come, you're still on the road to ruin. A road that leads directly to a confrontation with the Elder Brain.
I mean, that is the plan.
At best, it will kill you and everyone else in this city. At worst, it will assimilate you, and you won't have enough free will left to even wish you were dead.
Okay, I mean, if those are the two options, they both seem bad, but...
You have the key to destroying it in the palm of your hand, though.
The Astral Prism, or the Orpheus, yeah, but the Astral Prism?
In a manner of speaking, but it's the one inside the prism that you need, not the Illithid, the Gith. I can give you the means to break him free.
Huh. Why would I want to free him?
I suppose you'd rather suck on the Emperor's tentacles till the end of your days? Orpheus is your only hope of surviving.
I mean, Del's pretty open to things, but...
Without devolving into an Illithid. To you, he will be a friend. After all, you're at war with an Elder Brain.
Again, we're gonna, Del has a certain, he's gonna say this, the Emperor's the only reason I'm alive. He's, despite the fact that he's like, oh, you're not a, I can't remember what his dream visitor looked like. I think a drow. You know, you're not this drow lady. Other than that, I think he's probably still drinking the Kool-Aid. The Emperor's the only reason I'm alive. Well, that may be literally true, or rather that Orpheus is the reason. But the reason Orpheus is still locked in the prison that I can carry in my pocket is maybe because of the Emperor. So we're gonna... Shouldn't Lozelle be here? Is she not?
No. Orpheus is the only reason you're still alive. The Emperor is abusing the Gith for its own ends.
And I believe that. I believe that to be very true.
To you. You're nothing more than the beast of burden that will transport it to the Elder Brain. An ox requires food and the occasional beating to keep it moving. You are simpler. The Emperor's words serve as both carrot and stick.
Perhaps it is true that Orpheus would ally with you against the Elder Brain. But if he proves uncooperative once free, you may have to kill him.
In which case, where does that leave us, right? It's worth taking the risk, how do I feel? But that's the thing, is it? Wow, so I don't have the option of just saying no. I can just be like, I'm leaving and then, you know, come back later. The thing is, there's nothing wrong with us just saying this and then deciding what we're going to do about it later on, right?
Hey, Quill, pay attention. There's a new subscriber.
I mean, maybe Del just walks away. We'll probably be coming back here and doing some things later regardless. We could just walk away. I bet you we have to come here at some point, regardless, and continue this path. Huh. I want to just walk away here. Again, we're going to keep going with, currently Del has continued to drink the Kool-Aid. I want to see what happens with this path. So yeah, we're just gonna go, we're done here, I'm leaving. I don't trust you.
I won't stop you. But time is.
I strongly suspect at some point we're going to have to come back here. But I don't think Del's been broken from his belief that the Mind Flayer is doing the right thing by him right now.
Right up to the moment the world ends.
And yeah, and obviously he's a jerk. It's funny, they used like a texture projection thing for the decals here, which kind of smears them oddly on the vertical surface. Nice quarters he's got himself in the Devil's Den. Got a staircase we could follow down here.
There you are.
Oh.
I thought I'd lost you.
Ah, yes.
Something was blocking me from hearing your thoughts.
Yeah, funny that. It's Raphael. I know I was worried. I'm glad to have you back. It's nice to have a moment of peace and quiet. I don't know if I was worried. I don't know if I'm... Am I glad to have him back? This might be a moment for a bit of a snarky thing. Because here's the thing. As much as Del definitely doesn't trust Raphael, maybe Raphael has successfully injected a little bit of doubt. I'm tempted to say one just because, like, to prompt a feedback. Oh, it was Raphael. What do you think about that? Huh? What is your retort to this whole situation? I think I'm going to go with one.
Raphael. Well... Thank you for your honesty. Of course, I should have known the devil would come sniffing. The stench of impending chaos is irresistible to them. And what did he want with you?
Again, I'm interested about the information that I would get from one. Right, there's this problem that happens when you play D&D where, like, your PCs are, like, just paranoid about everything and they refuse to, like, engage with anything, and then the story just doesn't move forward because it's really awkward. I think I'm going to say three.
I see.
You might still just be able to read my mind.
You feel the touch of the Emperor's mind peeling at the edge of yours, trying to gain access.
Hmm. You're the one who's always talking about trust. If you trust me, you'll stop this right now.
That is a fair request.
You feel its presence withdrawing from the fringes of your awareness.
I shall respect your privacy on this occasion. But know that if you have jeopardized our mutual project, I will be forced to
start wearing Omelium's Ring of Mind Shielding.
Alliance. Now come. We have an Elder Brain to destroy.
I mean, I like playing Destroy the Elder Brain. I mean, admittedly, the Absolute is sort of a victim in all this, but we can't let the Elder Brain go free. That's
a journey to the Underdark.
Hmm. Yeah, on this occasion, I know. Oh, right. I have to go back down to the bar room to talk to Voss. Yeah, go to Snape and learn Occlumency.
In a word, sir.
We are not in trouble, sir. Remember our vow to keep one another safe. Tell me you took the devil's deal. Tell me you will free Gith's heir.
Oh, there's that whole aspect. And Lazelle would definitely be a fan of that. Huh. I think Orpheus does need to be freed. And I think Del thinks that Orpheus needs to be freed. But Del still has the means justifying the ends thing for him personally. When did this become a rosy tone? Might just be the light in the room. No, I'll find another way to liberate Orpheus. That doesn't mean it doesn't require a devil deal with the devil.
I did not come this far for you to turn your back on the first mother's son.
He lost an ear.
And yet it seems I have no choice but to trust. There is but one prism, and you are its key. Raphael possesses a powerful relic called the Orphic Hammer.
That hammer is the only thing capable of smashing the chains that bind the Prince of the Comet. Find a way to retrieve the hammer and free Orpheus from the prism. I will assemble his remaining honor guard and plan our next actions.
I mean, I suppose
together, we will yet free the true heir of Gith's blessing.
I suppose the only reason we didn't free Orpheus.
Free us from Vlakith and lead our Kithraki against the Geich.
That sounds really good.
Is Tick. I will wait in the underground. Seek me when you have the hammer in hand.
Okay. The only reason we didn't free Orpheus or weren't immediately pursuing that is because we were told by the Emperor that, like, oh, Orpheus will just see you as, like, an agent of the Mind Flayer because you got the worm, and he's going to turn on you and kill you instantly. But if we've been introduced to this moment of doubt, maybe Del is like, hold on. Maybe that the only reason I think that is because the Emperor told me this. And if it's not true, if Orpheus would ally with us to overthrow the Absolute, in fact, Mind Flayers in general, that seems like a really decent idea. I mean, I guess the Emperor is 100% sure that Orpheus would kill him immediately, and that is probably true. And yeah, I think Vlakith does need to be overthrown. Yeah. Orpheus sensed the tadpole before his guard attacked. Won't he attack if we free him? Perfect.
The Prince of the Comet aches for Githyanki liberation more than he abhors.
The trade button's grayed out.
He might seethe when you free him. He might gnash his teeth and slander your name. But he will see reason. I promise you.
Any idea where Raphael may keep the Orphic hammer?
A devil of Raphael's stature does not simply make camp on the shores of the Styx. He will have made a sanctuary for himself, a lavish one that caters to his many vices. He must keep the Orphic hammer there. Every house has an entrance, Istik. Even those in the Hells. You must find it.
Oh, wow. His sword's literally available for sale. Interplanet Slayer. This weapon grants a D4 bonus to damage and attack rolls against Githyanki, Aberrations, Fiends, and Elementals. So presumably the 1D4 Psychic is from the Interplanar Slayer, so it's not always on. It's a +2 longsword with a Wrathful Smite built in as an option. Boss's Silver Sword. I mean, because we could... Oh, so this is not... Is this the one that you can disarm from him early on and then give it to Lazel? But I thought that was one where it was like, it only worked if you were Githyanki. This just works for everyone. I think it would say conditional if it wasn't for the buff. Thought your game was bugged here and letting you do this. I mean, it feels a little odd. And Lazel doesn't really use longsword stuff, although a different sword, okay. Letter to Voss. I mean, the Psychic Rider is really good. I don't think we really have anyone in our party set up for this. If I come here with my sword and board paladin, then I might be tempted to pick that up. And attack rolls. Okay, that is actually... It's not just damage, it's also the attack rolls. It does read as the D4 Psychic separate from the conditional, but after the Staff of Ultimate Blast, I don't trust the teletips that much. Yeah, it's really not clear. And yeah, it is versatile, so we can still two-hand it. I mean, 1d10 is not that far off from 2d6, although it sort of kind of is. But with all the bonuses... F it. You know what? We'll buy it. It might just sit in our box. But you know, we spent lots of money this stream. We can keep spending money.
Rumple isn't right.
You are wasting your time and mine. Our true enemy is the Elder Brain. Focus your mind there.
Yeah. All right, we're going to go to camp.
Human born, she gets waiting. Playing
here. You're kidding. I think what we might do... It would have been really interesting to do this with Lazel, although she might have been like, yeah, we have to do the deal with the devil, even if it wasn't the most brilliant of situations. Oh, Will's got dialogue. We've got to end the stream, so I'm a little leery about diving in there. Well, okay, we'll do this. Because what I'm considering is, what if we drop Karlak? She's had her fun at the circus. We could bring in Lazelle, although we've already done these conversations. But if we are going to go and pursue some things over here. Track down his lavish abode in the Helds. The House of Hope may be our best bet. Help Kithrak. Explore the city, see if we find any leads. I don't know. I kind of think we might bring Lazelle with us next time. But let's talk to Will and see what's going on.
Men, women, children, all barred from entry. A damn travesty. A decade ago, Baldur's Gate would have welcomed any and everyone seeking refuge. Who would take in these souls, if not the Jewel of Baldurin?
A shame. Baldur's Gate was a safe refuge when I left it. This must be Gortash's doing.
As long as Gortash is in charge, they'll be left shivering at the gates. All part of the plan, of course.
As long as Lazelle gets space paint, I'm okay with dropping Karlak.
Create an army and order it to march on the city. Step two, shut the gates in the name of security. Step three, bask in the applause. Gortash hasn't made Baldur's Gate safe. He's made it a prison. And when his army breaks through, the people will have nowhere
to
run.
How old is Del supposed to be? Older.
To make this city a safe haven, yeah. We'll need to
bathe Gortash
and his allies in their own blood.
So what I'm going to do is...
to be alive.
Face paint. I was going to go... I'll probably do this in between streams, but I'll probably remove all the equipment for Karlak. Well, probably not the Mighty Cloth and the Brace of Defense, because no one's going to be using that. But... the rest of it, and a part of it is like I might just want to take some pictures here to make sure I, you know, can rebuild the setup. And then yeah, take all this off, and then take everything and just send it to Del, for example, and then remove her from the party.
No one stopped me.
And then
yet.
I'm gonna reorganize Lazelle, who probably needs level ups and everything. Karlak's right over here, eh?
I have a lot on my mind.
Yeah, if we're going to hell, Karlak and Will is a good idea. I just don't know if we're going to go there yet, but we'll probably see about doing some swaps.
Really? 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 Oh, fine. I'll be here eating dirt.
And I guess we don't have to bring Lazelle to hell with us. But it will be kind of interesting seeing her reaction to various random things around town just to shake things up. I don't know where Lazelle is. Maybe she's like way over here? No, that's us. This is where we spawn in. Oh, down here? Yes, I don't know. I'm a little torn. I do agree. If we go to Raphael's place, Will and Karlak, a great idea. Where is she in this? And yeah, I kind of just want to talk to Lazelle on stream as well, because I would assume she might have a conversation. How much else to this area is there? There's nothing over there. In front of the beds. That's not clear enough. She's near Will. Oh, there she is. Come on, Dot. Yeah, I'm super duper overrated. There's finally the Dot for Lazelle. Alright. Yeah, I'm surprised there's no exclamation mark. She might still have a little bit of commentary. Wow.
Inconceivable that we would seek release from one tadpole only for you to commune with another. I chide you if my mind were not consumed by the sight of Orpheus within his domed prison. The Prince of the Comet lives, but make no mistake. I can see the change in you, feel the parasite worming its way through
a little bit, yeah. Further.
You have invited your own misery. I will not break our alliance for it, but I will not condone it.
I should have put some face paint on. Yeah. All right, well, you know what? We're going to do this conversation next time.
It is done.
Because it is 4, we're going to wrap it up. But Wednesday, we're going to stream more of this. We're going to talk to Laezel. We will commit to freeing Orpheus. We're going to see if we can do it without freaking signing a contract with Raphael, though. Because that seems like a really, really, really bad idea. As far as the Illithid stuff, Del may just accept that at this point he's, you know, kind of far gone. I don't think he wants to go through full Ceramorphosis, but I don't know if he's like, you know, he might be like, after this is all done, maybe that's just going to be the end of me. But at least we'll have saved the world. I don't know. Normie's TV. What? No. What? No. What? That can't be actually true. Seriously? Yeah, okay. Normies! Hey, shout out for reacting to, what's my favorite thing you're reacting to right now? Buffy, I guess? And tons of series? I watch Normies all the time. All the time. But we are going to wrap up the live stream right here. Unfortunately, that is some bad timing. I'm very sorry. We're just wrapping it up. Wednesday's our next live stream. We're going to be continuing some more Baldur's Gate 3. And for now, we're going to see if A Kiss for Luck is streaming. And we're going to give a raid over there. What's happening over there? Oh, Elder Scrolls Online they're doing. So we're going to give it a raid that way. Thanks, everyone, for coming out. I really appreciate you. I'll see you on Wednesday. Thanks to the normies for coming by. Probably time for me to check my subscription, see if there's a new episode or something or other. And yeah, I'll see you on Wednesday. Bye, everyone.